Canadian Girls. This is based on my formative years in the Comox Valley in the 70s. Anybody who was on the West Coast in the 70s may find some images to identify with. Canadian Girls. We were Canadian girls, and we crushed on hockey players. Not the goofy boys in our classrooms, sweaty, pock-faced hormone sacks. Oh no, we crushed on NHL. Val would choose Serge Savard, a shot at the savage perhaps, a flirt with passion, then concession that she'd love to spin with such a reputable defender. Habs fan as well, but for me, Cornwallier, modest in post-game interview, a clever roadrunner on the ice. I could have slid into that adorable smirk. We girls gabbed into the night, deep stuff. God and sin and what if boy questions. Our friends at school, the guys, not hockey players, discussed God and sin with us. They were frozen out. No opening, no shot at making the cut. For we were Canadian girls, submerged in our own youth. No notion of the clouds in their complacence, the storm behind the nice faces. Michael died, a motorcycle crash. It was his seventh that finally took him. Gregory, always more honest, in the end, he chose a gun. We were Canadian girls, and we crushed on hockey players and worried a little bit about us. Could hetero girls love each other? Romance was the cinematic flavor du jour, Butch and Sundance, the odd couple. Sisterances surely happened also. Patience was rewarded with Thelma and Louise, beaches. American as well, and long past the years of doubt. Nevertheless, validation while Carol Pope entranced and scandalized us. We adopted our new flag, amused and confused by our grandparents' hatred of it as they clung on, loyal to a mash of British Union Jack and sovereign coat of arms. Their champion, Diefenbaker, just our wrinkle-faced curmudgeon with no relevance to girls like us, as smugly estranged from the UK as USA. Western, small L liberals. We loved to hate or hated to love Trudeau. Of course, he played some hockey, captain of his college team, for without that, he wouldn't have had a chance. Never would have guessed his gossip fodder romance would create another charmer for our kids to love-hate. Four decades passed and more, a Trudeau once again looks great beside our southern cousin's calamity in the White House. Replay. We were Canadian girls, and we crushed on hockey players. Living on an island so far west that hockey was our best, if not sole, link to La Belle Province, that in mandatory Classe de Français. The shadow of the FLQ more distant than the dark losses of Berkeley or even Kent, Ohio. We devoured the news about the State University massacre and later Patty Hearst events, more voracious than for the sad drama of Messieurs Cross or Laporte. The Liberation Front and their demands no more or less meaningful to us than Vietnam or the Middle East, than Idi Amin or Gloria Steinem. Lord Stanley's Cup more consequential to us than all of them together. Everyone on the coast was from somewhere else, with fealty to Maple Leafs or Les Habitants. Loyalty untouched by the expansion till embrace of the Canucks by the big boys of the NHL, the big league. Now we had to choose. As the Cold War eased to thermal calm, Montreal and Toronto fans mirrored an uneasy detente, mutually rooting for Vancouver when neither of the two eastern towns were in that night's game. Not yet having flames from Calgary to boo, any U.S. team was equal fair game to hiss and heckle, too. We are Canadian women. Haley's our hockey crush now, on side with Wayne and Sid. We live in a condo downtown. We live in a bungalow out in the suburbs. We live in a white cottage with goats and chickens. We've left our puck infatuations on ice, treat ourselves with kindness that we hadn't known we deserved. We love hockey with our families and remember old hockey crushes as we form new ones on our sons and daughters as they slide and skate and trip and shoot and score.